Hey, this is Marty from Blue Lightning TV. I'm going to show you how to quickly transform text or design into realistic shiny plastic and how to quickly change its color. I provided this texture that you could use for the background. Its link is in my video's description or project files. Feel free to use any dark background you like. Before we begin, if you want to know as soon as I upload new Photoshop tutorials, smash that subscribe button, and please remember to click like if you like this video. Thank you. Open a black and white design that you'd like to use for this project. You could also type out text instead of using a design. The layer style setting amounts I'll be using in this tutorial are based on designs or text with thick shapes and whose size are at least this large on our screen. For designs or text that have thinner shapes or are smaller in size, many of the layer style setting amounts should be reduced to give the best plastic-looking results. To ensure that your design is pure black and white, open levels by pressing Ctrl or Command L. If the input black and white levels aren't all the way to the left and right edges, drag their respective sliders to just inside their peaks. Then click OK or press Enter or Return. Click the lock icon to unlock the background and open the Channels panel. If you don't see it, go to Window and Channels. Control or Command click any of the channels to select the shape of your design. Open back the Layers panel and press the Delete key to delete everything white. Deselect it by pressing Control or Command D. With your Move tool active, drag it onto the tab of the dark background. Without releasing your mouse or pen, drag it down and release. To center it over the background, go to View, and if Snap isn't checked, click it. Drag your design or text over the background until it snaps to the center. You'll see a box outline surrounding your text and may see that the X and Y coordinates are both 0 pixels. Both are indicators that it's centered. Double-click an empty area of the layer to open its layer style window. Click Color Overlay and the Color box. In the hexadecimal field, type in 8 and 5 zeros. Later, I'll show you how to change the overall color of the design or text. The opacity is 100%. Click Bevel and Emboss. The style is inner bevel, the technique is smooth, and the depth is 32%. The direction is up, the size is 31 pixels, and soften it 2 pixels. Global light is unchecked, the angle is 150 degrees, and the altitude is 46 degrees. Open the Gloss Contour presets. Click the gear icon and click Small List. If you don't see Ring Triple in your list, click Contours and Append. Open the Contour presets and click Ring Triple. The highlight mode is green, the color is white, and the opacity is 75%. The shadow mode is irrelevant since its opacity is 0%. Click Contour. Open the Contour presets and click Ring Double. The range is 100%. Click Inner Glow. The blend mode is Multiply, the opacity is 50%, and the noise is 0. The color is black, the technique is softer, and the source is Edge. The choke is 10%, the size is 30 pixels, and the contour is linear. The face of our design or text is presently a bit too bright, so we'll correct that. Press Ctrl or Command J to make a copy of the layer. Double-click Bevel and Emboss to see it in the Layer Style window. Make the altitude 45 degrees and reduce its opacity to 60%. We'll convert our plastic design or text into a smart object by shift-clicking Layer 1 to make it active as well and converting the two layers into one smart object. Double-click an empty area of the layer to open its layer style window. Click Inner Glow. Change the blend mode to Color Dodge and its opacity to 25%. The color is white. The source is center. The choke is 15%. And the size is 25 pixels. Click Drop Shadow. The blend mode is linear burn. The color is black. And the opacity is 10%. The angle is 90 degrees. The distance is 20 pixels. The spread is 0. And the size is 15 pixels. Lastly, I'll show you how to quickly change its color. Click the adjustment layer icon and click Hue Saturation. Since adjustment layers affect all the layers below them in the Layers panel, we'll need to make it into a clipping mask since we want it to affect just the one layer below it. To do this, click the clipping mask icon or go to Layer and create clipping mask. Drag the hue slider to the right and left until you find a color you like. This is Marty from Blue Lightning TV. Thanks for watching.